Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Hello everyone. So today I'm going to be doing a presentation. I forgot what it's called, but like yeah, we basically have to present about a favorite country or something like that. So today I'm going to be choosing a historical one that doesn't exist anymore, sadly. So let me just show you. Let's see. As you see, this is the flag. This is a very cool flag, you know. So it's called the Republic of Yugoslavia, or also known as the Socialist Republic of Yugoslavia. So it is a country in Eastern Europe, or the Balkans specifically. As you see, this flag is has a blue, white, and red color, and also a red star, usually associated with socialist countries. Although this one, socialist, is not actually affiliated much with the Soviet Union, because the Cold War was partially neutral. So let's just continue. So as you see, we're going to be talking about quite an important figure. This man is called Josip Broz Tito. Josip Broz Tito was a revolutionary and also partisan leader of Yugoslavia during the Second World War. So Yugoslavia was currently a monarchy, and then they got invaded by Italy, and then they retaliated, and then also Germany decided to help Italy, and then they decided to war. So during those years where Yugoslavia's areas was occupied, there were several resistance groups. This one is the partisans led by Josip Broz Tito, and they managed to held out and also win against those Germans. And this is pretty good because, you know, he's quite a good leader, I think. He also met with our president, okay, Sukarno, and he also founded the Non-Aligned Path or movement. I think that's what it's called, and I guess that's basically it. He died in the late 1990s, and that's when the country started going downhill. So let's actually look at the geography or something. So as you see, it spans an area of 255,804 square kilometers. For what? For you Americans out there, I'm not sure how to translate this into whatever you use, because I don't think you use kilometers, but as you see, this is the area of the Balkans. Now this map is currently in the Cold War era, so as you see, because there's the Soviet Union, West Germany, East Germany, and then the Berlin area. So this is Yugoslavia. Now the border countries of Yugoslavia is Italy, Austria, Hungary, Romania, Bulgaria, Greece, and also Albania. Albania is Balkan, but it's not part of Yugoslavia. So over here we have this part, the northern ones, it's called Croatia, and then this one, Bosnia and Herzegovina, and then this one is Serbia itself, Kosovo is over here, or something, I forgot. Oh yeah, Slovenia also over here, and then Montenegro. And also one plus one, Macedonia. Yeah, I guess that's about it. And they also border the Aegean Sea, which goes from the Mediterranean all the way to the North Atlantic. And yeah. So, with all that being said, I think we should go to the most fun part of the presentation. That's the Yugoslav War itself. As you see, this is a pretty huge summary, and I'm just going to be quickly going over it. Now, as you see, there's a lot of kids there, and I'm going to be using it for reference. As you see, this man is a dictator. Now, he's not really an animal, but he's something that I will show you. So this one is a tank, with a Yugoslav flag. I think that's one of the Serbian ones. And this one is a Serbian. This is the flag of Kosovo. This is Croatia. This is the shield of Bosnia. This one's a Njaka of Serbia for some reason. This one is Albania, and this one is, I forgot which one is it, probably Serbian or Kosovo Croatian army, which is funded by Albania. And yeah. Okay, let's just go over it. Okay. So as you see, the date started on 31st of March 1991 all the way to the 12th of November 2001. So it took like at least 10 years, enough for a child to grow, mature, something like that. And then the five days. So the Yugoslav wars actually consists of several wars. The Slovenian War of the war is actually quite huge, one of the biggest after the Second World War. As you see, the total US is around 1,300 to 1,330,000. Yeah, something like that. And a lot of people displaced, like around 4 million or something. But that's okay, because that's not in our area, right? So, oh yeah, I forgot to start some gifts. As you see, this is just a spinning toilet, just to remind you that we're living in a not so good country. So let's just move on. So there's also a lot of war crimes. War crimes are the act of doing something bad in war, like towards civilian. And this is one of them, the negative bombing of Yugoslavia. Now this is quite controversial. Some people say that it's justified, some people say no. But as you see, this is the city of Novi Sad on fire because it got bombed. Oblivion. So the casualties, as you see, I got them a country bowl with Kosovo right on the door. Because why not? Now, as you see, this is the NATO forces, 3 jet fighters destroyed, 2 aircraft destroyed, 46 UAVs destroyed, 3 destroyed, so damaged, 2 Polish killed, non-combat helicopter crash, and also 3 soldiers captured. While on the Serbian losses, there's a lot, and also economic losses of 29.6 million. Oh, that's fun. Human rights was estimated that a lot of civilians died, and that's basically how to summarize. So, after going through all of that, let's just move on, okay? Now there's, yeah. So let's talk about something much nicer. The cuisine, of course! How else are you going to talk about your favorite country without mentioning the cuisine? It's totally not an act, just to make the video longer. Now, as you see, there's a lot of Yugoslavian cuisine, okay? Like Serbian, like, yeah, a lot. Because, like Indonesia, it's not specific. So, but today I'm going to be showing you specific Serbian ones, because why not? As you see, this is the breakfast. They eat stuff like Europeans, not rice. So this is porridge. As you see, I assume it's pretty sweet. And then burek, something like that. Kibris, which looks like a croissant. And then kacama, which is probably eggs and stuff. And then kajuna and bawara. I'm not sure how to say it, but yeah, that's breakfast in Serbia. And then there's also the appetizers. So yeah, as you see, there's this, which looks like cheese and also meat. Zimnica, which looks like an assortment of vegetables. Mez, which is something like this. They look the same, they look like salads or something, but I suppose that's about it. So, let's see. After that... Oh, I forgot something important. Let's just reverse now. Before you may ask, okay, why would I reverse here? Now there's a lot of important reasons, and that's because I forgot to mention something. Now, as you see, I forgot to describe these pictures, because why not? It's fun. As you see, there's people marching, soldiers specifically, and then there's a tank, there's a destroyed building, and also a field for labor, and also refugees. Refugees. Do you know about refugees? Rohingyas? People? Okay. So as you see, yeah, there's a lot of stuff. But I guess that's about it. Let's just continue, go over to all this nonsense that I created for some reason. I am doing this just to show you all the hard work I've done on this presentation. So after all that time, we finally come to the end. But of course, it's not going to be the end without me drawing with my pen tablet. I'm going to show you. So, what did we learn from this video? Oh my god, I just learned that I cannot use the pen tablet because I haven't put it on yet. There you go. I should be able to. Why? Okay. Okay. So, you may be asking. Let me just draw a representation of you. This is probably you right now. And then you're saying, okay, but like, why won't you show us this? Why? I am confused. I would like to ask. And then this is just me. I wear a tinfoil hat because I'm probably a conspiracy theorist. And I'd say that this is quite important because Yugoslavia is quite similar to Indonesia. It has a lot of ethnicities and well, it's also big, and it's also got a history of friendship. So, because Yugoslavia fell, there's something that we can learn as Indonesians, and that is that unity is great. Because, you know, the difference between us and Serbia, or Yugoslavia, is that Yugoslavia was basically a patchwork of kingdoms with historical values, and that means that ethnicities doesn't really like each other. But except that, that's different, because us Indonesians, as you see, we both, we have a lot in common. This is Indonesians, no matter who you are. I don't know who these people are. But we got enslaved, I think, for like a few hundred years by the Dutch, Japanese, and also a lot of stuff. We've been through a lot of stuff, and I guess that's just why we're united. And I guess that's about it. Thank you for listening to my Victor presentation. Hold on, I'm going to show you something else. Laser pointer. It exists. Okay, thank you for watching. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.